Good afternoon, and welcome to the convocation ceremonies for College of Education students graduating in the summer or fall of 2018. My name is Denise Spangler, and I have the privilege of serving as the Dean of the College of Education. The college was founded in 1908 to bring teacher education to the state of Georgia. Since then, we have grown and matured as a college, branching out into fields as diverse as speech pathology, athletic training, sport management, and student affairs leadership. The mission of the College of Education is to enhance the well-being of society through scholarship, teaching, and research. And we achieve this mission through the hard work and dedication of our 4,200 students, approximately 300 of whom are graduating today, our 220 faculty, and our 150 staff members. This is a day to celebrate our graduates and their passion for learning and helping others. To help us mark this special occasion and to give you an image of the future that you have ahead of you, we have invited one of our distinguished alumni to address our graduates. This year's speaker has had a remarkable career, and we're honored that she is with us to celebrate this special occasion. In a moment, I will call on Marcus Dexter, a doctoral student in the Sport Management Program in the Department of Kinesiology, to introduce our speaker. Mr. Dexter is a former college athlete and college track coach, and his research interest is in the experiences of academically and athletically high-achieving African-American male college athletes. Mr. Dexter is actively involved in our Student Ambassador Program, and he serves as a graduate assistant in the university's Office of Institutional Diversity. Mr. Dexter, please come to the program and introduce our speaker.
Good afternoon, and congratulations to the College of Education's Fall 2018 graduates. Today, I have the distinct pleasure of introducing to you someone who had inspired me years before I had the privilege and honor of meeting her, Ms. Dominique Holloman. To say that she is someone who loves UGA would be an understatement. For many of you, this is your first of hopefully several degrees from UGA, and others possibly your second. Are there any triple dogs in the building? Hey. Well, believe it or not, Ms. Dominique Holloman has a total of 4 degrees from UGA. She is a quad dog. 2 bachelors, a master's of education from our amazing college, and a Juris Doctorate from the School of Law, which she got in conjunction with her MED. As can be expected of the inaugural president of the UGA Black Alumni Leadership Council, taking on the challenges and succeeding is what Ms. Holloman does well. Currently, she serves on the UGA Alumni Association Board of Directors and the UGA Board of Visitors, in addition to being an alumni member of the inaugural statewide class of the Zell Miller Leadership Institute. Ms. Holloman is also a 2017 inductee into the Alumni Association's 40 Under 40 and serves as the Chief of Staff for Representative William Bodie of Georgia House District 62. While prestigious, these are just a few of the positions that Ms. Holloman holds. To list all of her awards, accolades, and positions would take up all the time that I was allotted. But what is essential to highlight are the personal and professional passions Ms. Holloman has for giving back and making it possible for others to thrive. Her legacy of humility, encouragement, affirmation, and love will truly stand the test of time, not just here at UGA, but throughout the state of Georgia. Dominique, I always get sad when I go to this part. On a more personal note, I cannot thank you enough for all that you continue to do for current and future Georgia students, as well as your tireless efforts to ensure the state of Georgia is one that we all can be proud of. Your advocacy and generous nature encourage us all to leave as strong of a legacy at our fine institution as you have. Maya Angelou articulated best when she said, "People will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." In time, my friend, as we honor giants such as Charlene Hunter Gault, Hamilton Holmes, and Miss Mary Frances Early, I am confident that we will be speaking your name in such high regards. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming the Fall 2018 College Education Convocation Speaker, Ms. Dominique Holloman.
Good afternoon. Thank you to Marcus for such a glowing introduction. They say what people think about you is none of your business. However, it is nice to know that someone you think so highly of thinks the same of you. It is my distinct honor and pleasure to be here today, and I extend immense gratitude to Dean Spangler for the invitation. To the leadership of the College of Education, university officials, College of Education faculty, and other honored guests on the stage with me and in the audience, I am humbled by your presence today. Your service to these students we are here to acknowledge and celebrate, and your indulgence of my well wishes. To today's graduates, I appreciate that I had the privilege to be such a part of a special day for you. It is a momentous day for me as well, and I'm delighted to share it with you. When I initially received the invitation to speak with you today, I was quite shocked. I was unaware that I had grown in wisdom or stature. However, we rarely see in ourselves what others see in us, and I'm happy to note what has been reflected back to me. After immediately accepting, I set about determining what it was I wanted to leave with you today. I asked advice of friends who had delivered convocation speeches, expecting to receive an amazing topic that I could wow you with. I was told to simply be myself. What did that mean, I wondered. I began to think back on my own convocation 14 falls ago and the professional journey I have been on since that December, with all of my hopes, goals, dreams, and plans for my future in my head and my heart, what message could I have left with that would have prepared me for the ride? I'm certain all of you have made plans for, are in the process of making plans for, or considering the next steps. Some of you are at the beginning of a career journey, some of you are in the middle of walking your path, and some of you, this degree marks a shift in your path, a change in direction. A start of something new for you. You are all goal-oriented people, as evident by us gathering here to celebrate your significant personal and professional accomplishments. So I know you are planners and organizers. I'm certain the most organized of you made a checklist today. No judgment. I too am a planner and organizer. Giving thoughtful consideration to my life helps me plan for the big picture. What I want to talk with you today about, though, is the devil in the details of these plans that we have for ourselves, and about when things do not go according to plan, when there are setbacks, disappointments, and major disruptions. In law school, I begin the habit of writing reminders to myself and placing them on my dresser mirror. Sometimes they were notes of encouragement, or a mantra, or a funny quote I had read. I still maintain that habit today. Some quotes I keep posted for years, while others are posted for a season. When I am extremely organized, these notes get placed in my journal with thoughts of reflection. When I'm not so organized, they get misplaced. For today's message, I actually had to clean my room to find this special reminder. And it reads, be process-driven, not goal-driven. My message for you today is in all of your planning, list making, goal setting, and checking of boxes is to trust the process. Trust is a tricky thing. In our relationships, trust is confidence that our friends, our family, our partners, or significant others, that we receive their best. We can recognize when trust is absent, and we can recognize when trust is broken. Sometimes we know how to restore it, and sometimes we cannot figure out how to make it grow. In the plans for our lives, though, trust shows up as hope. It is hope for a vibrant future, hope that our hard work will reap a just reward, hope that our dreams will come true. So then what is hope, you may ask? Desire, anticipation, expectation. How then, when you sense your plans are going off the rails, do you maintain hope? How do you have confidence that focusing on the process and not the goal will lead to fulfillment? I have learned three lessons that have helped me. Keep your axe sharp. You may have heard the tale of the woodcutting contest. Two woodcutters were competing for a job. They were told whomever had chopped the most wood at the end of the day would receive the job. The first woodcutter worked as long and hard and fast as he could all day. The second woodcutter chopped diligently for a while, and then she would take leave for breaks. The first woodcutter could not understand where the second woodcutter was going or what she was doing. This pattern continued throughout the day. The first woodcutter was confident that he would win the job, as he had to have chopped the most wood. At the end of the day, the wood was counted. The second woodcutter had chopped the most. In his disbelief, the first woodcutter inquired as to how this was possible. The second woodcutter told him that while he chopped nonstop, she took breaks to sharpen her axe. What does this look like in our lives? We see our friends, our colleagues, our classmates achieving their goals, or even our goals faster than we are. We perhaps have to turn our focus on being a parent or a partner or a caregiver, and we think we're behind on checking those boxes. I at one time believed I was. I was so discouraged and frustrated at feeling like I was failing because I was not meeting my goals. The first third of my career, I worked in college athletics. Working in athletics was simply supposed to be the means to an end in my plans, not the plan. A one-year gig, a stepping stone, not the 5 years it became. In those years, I married, had a child, divorced, lost a parent, and worked at a state institution through a recession. That meant no raise. I felt sidelined, but I doubled down. I sat on every campus-wide committee I could. I accepted an appointment to our board of Campus Women's Leadership Initiative and chaired a mentorship and development program. I partnered with other departments to create and host programming around specific initiatives. While I was waiting on greater opportunities, I deepened my knowledge and expanded my skill set. While seemingly stuck, I sharpened my axe. I became better, so when given the opportunity again to chop wood, I would be prepared. This leads me to my second point. Say yes to your bigger yes, or rather, say no to great but irrelevant opportunities. Both of these sayings are also in my current rotation of notes, and they remind me to not make just good choices, but the best choices. Do know that what is a good choice and what is the best choice are often not the same thing. Prior to my current transition into politics, a mentor suggested that I take my transferable skill set from corporate relations to fundraising and development. I have always been happy to ask other people for money from all the practice I had with my parents. My mom is here, she can confirm that. And having been tasked with saying no in compliance work, I'm not easily deterred by being told no. After several months of her sending job postings my way, there was finally one that was perfect. I could not have created a better opportunity. I was thrilled that I had been personally endorsed by the job because I absolutely wanted it. Upon applying, I was told the position needed to be filled immediately and then to anticipate a short interview and hiring process. Well, 4 months later, interviews were finally conducted for the position. However, in those 4 months, my personal obligations and commitments had changed. And while still an outstanding professional opportunity for someone, that job was no longer an outstanding opportunity for me, and it was best for me to say no. And had I said yes, I would not have been able to engage in the many activities I have, specifically over the last 2.5 years, that have been meaningful, impactful, and quite honestly, life-changing for me, such as serving as the inaugural president of the UGA Black Alumni Leadership Council. Though I made the best decision in that instance, plans do have a way of turning on themselves. In striving, you may feel the sting of disappointment at times when situations do not go according to plan, or sometimes seemingly any plan. Let's discuss my final point. Remember, life is long. Earlier, I shared with you that this was a momentous day for me as well. This is because this convocation is a life do-over moment for me. I did not attend my own convocation. At the time, I was completing the internship required for my master's degree. It was in an athletic compliance office, and my commitment was for the academic year. For 9 months, I spent the morning on campus and the afternoon at another job. Since I had requested 3 days off to sit for the bar exam, I was told that I would have to make up those hours as opposed to simply not being paid for them. So I made a decision not to request any additional time off and skipped my convocation. That was never my intention. As hard as I had worked to complete my dual degree, I wanted to celebrate both. Though I do not have regrets, I do have disappointments, and that decision to skip convocation has always been one. I was crushed to have made that choice. There are many times in life when we have made the presumption that a missed opportunity will never be experienced again. I tell you, I do not find that to be true. Instead, what I have found is that we receive do-over opportunities that we reject because they're not packaged like the original. We do not recognize these chances for what they are. You could not have told me 14 years ago that I would have the chance to experience convocation the way I am now. Life is funny, in that on our path of accomplishment, we are sometimes having to hurry up and wait. In hurrying towards what we want, though, in haste we may miss it. And while waiting for what we want, we can begin to believe that we have missed it and stop looking for it. But in attaining our goals, we have to be flexible as to what our outcome looks like and attentive to how opportunities are packaged. These three ideas taught me to trust the process. To allow for the process, though, we have to have patience. Too often, we think of patience as not being hasty or the ability to bear without complaining. However, I've learned to think of patience as the ability to endure. Endure changes, disappointments, setbacks, and other difficulties. Patience gives us the ability to trust the process. Now, don't doubt that I haven't struggled mightily with the idea. I have a note in my journal from last December that speaks to this. It reads, "Patient people are those who can bear trials and have equanimity. They're able to put up with delays, wait for the right moment, and bide their time. When your plans skew left and you feel tempted to be discouraged, I encourage you to be patient and remain hopeful, believing that what you desire, anticipate, and expect will be. And that even if it doesn't manifest as you plan, that you're able to recognize it and celebrate receiving it. Congratulations, graduates, on your outstanding accomplishment. Best wishes for your continued success. And as always, as we say in Bulldog Nation, go Dogs.
Thank you, Dominique. I hope that all of our graduates and all the rest of us will take your advice and remember to trust the process. Now we turn our attention to recognizing our graduates who have earned bachelor's degrees, master's degrees, or specialist degrees this semester. Each of you has accomplished something truly special through your hard work and dedication. I want to share a few statistics with you to help you put into perspective what you have achieved. A study from Harvard University showed that fewer than 7% of the people in the world hold a bachelor's degree. And according to the U.S. Census Bureau, only 9% of people in the United States have master's degrees, and only 2% have doctoral degrees. Stop and think about that for a minute. You are indeed among a very special group of people for what you have accomplished. And you didn't just earn a degree. Many of you have provided important service to the community through your service learning activities, contributed to building knowledge through research, or broadened your own horizons with experiential learning opportunities such as studying abroad or internships. Some of you earned your degrees while taking care of elderly parents or children, blazing your trail as the first person in your family to attend college. You all have indeed accomplished something to celebrate. In just a minute, we will begin the convocation process. The graduates will approach the stage from the audience's right, and they will be introduced by department and by degree. Please keep in mind that graduates will not necessarily be called in alphabetical order. Introducing our graduates today is Dr. Ann Marcotte, Professor of Communication Sciences and Special Education, and Department Head of Language and Literacy Education. Dr. Marcotte, please come to the podium.
We begin our recognition of graduates this afternoon with the Department of Career and Information Studies, which includes programs in learning, design, and technology, and in workforce education. This department and its alumni emphasize creativity and innovation in learning, instruction, scholarship, careers, and outreach for a wide range of in-school and out-of-school learning environments. The Department of Career and Information Studies is represented this afternoon by one graduate who has earned the degree Master of Education in Learning, Design, and Technology, Elizabeth Corrine Melendez. Our next graduates have earned degrees from the Department of Communication Sciences and Special Education, which focuses on the needs of persons who can benefit from a range of individualized approaches to teaching, learning, or communication. These new alumni are research-based professionals who will carry with them the department's mission of helping all persons realize their full potential in behavior, learning, and communication. The Department of Communication Sciences and Special Education is pleased to recognize two graduates this afternoon who have earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education with a major in Special Education. Natalie Elizabeth Vincenza Stout. And Ansley Virginia Roberts. The department is also proud to recognize several graduates who have earned master's degrees, either the Master of Arts in Teaching in Special Education or the Master of Education in Special Education. Shauna Brianna Dees. Carolyn Elizabeth Archambault. Alicia Marcel Godby. Amanda Catherine Freeman. Allison Claire Griffith. And Catherine Claire Price. Next, we recognize the Department of Educational Psychology, which focuses on how students think and learn, the science of giftedness and creativity, quantitative methodology, and best practices in the field of school psychology. Graduates of the Department of Educational Psychology serve our society as educators, school psychologists, researchers, and test developers, among many other roles. Educational psychology is represented this afternoon by one graduate who has earned the advanced degree Specialist in Education in Educational Psychology. Anita B. Hudson. The next graduates have all earned degrees from the Department of Educational Theory and Practice, which includes programs in early childhood education, middle grades education, and social studies education. This department prepares its alumni for careers as educators and researchers who are focused on children and adolescents, their families, and their communities, with an emphasis on fostering equity and social justice in education around the globe. The Department of Educational Theory and Practice is honored to present a large group of graduates this afternoon who have all earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education with a major in Early Childhood Education. Haley Brett Andrews. Lauren Margaret Watkins. Madison Marjorie Wiebe. Maggie Ellen Lumpkin. Vivian Lee Carbano. Catherine Grace Farmer. Anna Chapman Hunt. Sarah Olivia Power. Morgan Leanne Knowles. Morgan Lee Hollingsworth. Derry Elizabeth Rogers. Mackenzie Bree Maddie. Sahir Tajani. Alexandra Caitlin Kilkenny Smith.
Yeah.
Molly Kathleen McCoy. Sarah Marie Cravenhoff. Sydney Marie Mangus. Reagan E. Elder. Lakutanju Nzangan. Nell Lawson Bowling. Alicia C. Burgum. Chantel Elise Rogers. Autumn Ann Foss. Betsy Brown. Kristen Taylor Strout. Mary Catherine Killeen. Anna Lee Atwater. Margaret Lauren Davis. Joseph Zachary Allen. Liddell Mercer Watts. Elizabeth Lauren Perry. Christopher Curtis Pounds. Paige Allison Fearbaugh. Hannah Christine Shoemake. Julia Marie Midday. Lauren Juhi Chung. Neri Lyles Fiveash. Samantha Jane Williams. Lindsay Nicole Miles. Emma Deneen Kraling. Danica Ashley Nicchio. Dana Aurora Hurst. Kirsten Walanin. Caitlin Grace Stanton. Xingyu Li. Brandon Mitchell Hill. Morgan Emily Land. Karen Cole Acock. McKenna Nicole Windsor. Sarah Nicole Thompson. And Lara Nicole Hopper. We are also pleased to recognize graduates who have earned degrees in the Department of Educational Theory and Practice at the master's level, either the Master of Arts in Teaching or the Master of Education, in Early Childhood Education or in Middle Grades Education. Candace Rihanna Hooper. Elin Leo. Timothy Jerome Pritchett. Paige Christine Caffrey. Cora Janine Amon. Tori Grace Barnwell. Sheila Hamner Coffeen. Kristen Rebecca White. Lauren Alyssa Staley. Laura Beck Dunn. Brooklyn Elizabeth Inez Boyd. And Natalie Marie Tilly. Our next graduates have earned degrees from the Department of Kinesiology, which focuses on knowledge related to physical activity, exercise, and sport. The mission of this department is to enhance health and well-being for people throughout the lifespan through careers in allied health fields, in teaching and coaching, and in sport enterprises, as well as in higher education, government, and industry. The Department of Kinesiology is very proud of its many graduates who have earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education with majors in Exercise and Sport Science, Health and Physical Education, or Sport Management. Neely Noorparvar. Maxwell Lawrence Kassman. Clayton Rush Mormon. Sarah Elizabeth Carter. Ronald Blake Berg. Eric Ethan Dickinson. Sean Paul LaCroix. Margaret Catherine McGinty. Chelsea Leela Cowan. Mallory Michelle Huff. Druti Mukesh Patel. Brianna Lee Garris. Richard Gibb Pounds III. Jacob William Nidal. Catherine Lee Ryder. Rebecca Grace Lavender. Sarah Genevieve Williamson. Flory Olivia Taylor. Matthew Charles McKinney Scott. Marquise Dante Bryson. Leah Rebecca Early. Morgan Rachel Balsam. Uchenna Ugonabo. Kylie Madison Kelbaugh. Gerald Frank Johnson. And Tyler Robert Haland. The Department of Kinesiology is also pleased to present several graduates who have earned the degree Master of Science in Kinesiology. Lauren Elizabeth Rowland. Hunter Bradley Red. Sarah Martha Francis Gardner. And Shanice Georgetta Porter. We now turn to the Department of Language and Literacy Education. Through their knowledge of multimedia reading, composition, and interpretation, these graduates will provide learners and communities the tools they need to access, produce, and learn from languages and media at home, at school, and around the world. First, the Department of Language and Literacy Education is pleased to introduce one graduate who has earned a bachelor's degree, the Bachelor of Science in Education with a major in English Education, Rachel Dorothy Renbarger. The department is also proud to present graduates who've earned the degree Master of Education, either in English Education or in TESOL and World Language Education. Abigail Cheryl Letts. Julia Claire Simless. Kathleen Ivy Barrett. Ying Wang. Vicky Ann Hale. Pamela Lynn Paradise. Any other language and literacy? I'm sorry, do we have an EDS? That's it for language and literacy. Okay, we got it. Leap. We next recognize the Department of Lifelong Education, Administration, and Policy, which includes programs in Educational Administration and Policy, Learning, Leadership, and Organization Development, and Qualitative Research. Alumni from this department lead and improve educational programs in Georgia, the Southeast, and the nation to support schools for students in preschool through the 12th grade and serve in leadership roles in higher education, community agencies, and continuing education settings. The Department of Lifelong Education, Administration, and Policy is proud to present graduates who have earned the degree Master of Education in Human Resources and Organizational Development, or in Learning, Leadership, and Organizational Development. Young Ju Park. Captain Robert Carl Kelly. Christine Marie Foss. And Shalice Adria Brown. That brings us to our final department, the Department of Mathematics and Science Education. This department is recognized as a national leader in the research and practice of mathematics education and of science education, combining the expertise of its internationally known faculty with the energy and continuing innovation of its students and alumni. We are therefore very pleased to recognize our final group of graduates for summer and fall 2018, those who have earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education with a major in Mathematics Education or with a major in Science Education. Taylor Nicole Carbon. Shirley Chung. Lindsay Patton Weiss. And Emily Morgan Wilkins.
Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2018. At this time, I would like to recognize our graduates who have attained exceptional academic honors. And this is going to be a little tricky since they're seated behind you, but you can all turn around and stretch for a second. If you are graduating cum laude, please stand. You may be seated. If you are graduating magna cum laude, please stand. And if you are graduating summa cum laude, please stand. Finally, I want to recognize a truly stellar group of students, our first honor graduates who are graduating with a perfect 4.0 grade point average. First honor graduates, please stand. Congratulations to all of you on these outstanding achievements. It's now my pleasure to introduce our final speaker for the 2018 College of Education Convocation. Our student speaker is Autumn Foss, a senior majoring in early childhood education. Autumn is graduating with her bachelor's degree, and during her undergraduate career, she served as the executive director of the Lunchbox Garden Project, in which UGA students go to a local elementary school twice a week and work with children on developing a food garden and talk with them about nutrition, agriculture, and sustainability. She also served as Vice President for Community Outreach for Inspire UGA, an organization that encourages local students to graduate from high school and consider post-secondary options. She also worked with Trinity Woods Camp, serving as a counselor and then as assistant director. After graduation, Autumn hopes to obtain a position as an elementary school teacher right here in the Athens area, and we're thrilled that she could perhaps one day be a mentor teacher for some of our students. So Autumn's dedication and drive for academic excellence exemplify the best of the College of Education. So I'm pleased to ask her to come to the podium right now and address you.
As the great kid president said, two roads diverged in the woods, and I took the road less traveled by. And it hurt, man, really bad. Rocks, thorns, and glass, not cool, Robert Frost. We all took the road less traveled. We said, heck yeah, I want to serve people, serve all people. I know each of us has a different way that we all want to serve, but ultimately, we will be serving people. And let me tell you, I think we have found the rocks, thorns, and glass. These not so beautiful parts of the path were hidden in the early mornings, the late nights, the endless assessments, and the always a little more stressful than expected final projects and portfolios. But we survived them, since we're all sitting here. We're sitting at what many may call a finish line, but what others may say is a starting line of a marathon called life. Now, I could spend the rest of our time talking about the rocks, thorns, and glass on the road ahead. However, Kid President gives us two options. You can cry about it, or you can dance about it. So, let's talk about all the things that have made us dance for the last 4 years or so. Let's dance for the people who got us to this day. The family members, friends, supporters, and mentors who poured into us every day. The people who reminded us, hey, life is tough, but so are you. They have pushed us to be better people. They have answered the late night calls and the millions of I can't do this messages. They have supported us when we weren't able to stand on our own, believed in us before others even thought of us, and loved us when we quite possibly didn't even love ourselves. These people are the heroes of today, and they truly deserve the endless amount of hugs, pictures, and thank yous after today's convocation. Let's dance to the fact that we have the best professors and mentors in the land. From the professors who got us ready for the hours spent at sports internships, shadowing, and practicum placements, to the mentors in our desired professions who willingly opened up their spaces for us. These people pushed us to do better while also reminding us about the rocks in the way. They even reminded us that when we fail at first, that's normal, because our profession is an art. They reminded us to strive for better, not only for ourselves, but for the people we will serve. These mentors are continually trying to develop us, professionally and academically. They say that there are no perfect teachers, just people improving their practices every day. But I'd say the professors and mentors we have met here at UGA are as close to perfect as we can get. Let's dance to the community we have made here at the College of Education, to the friends who were there for us when we thought we couldn't make it any longer, the people who dragged us to our favorite study spots on campus the nights we needed to work, or dragged us into the city of Athens when we really just needed a night to unwind. The friends who understood the struggle of long days that for some of us included early mornings, and for others, late nights, and for those of us who procrastinated, it might have been a little bit of both. To the people who challenged our beliefs, understood our struggles, and inspired us every day to become better students, better sports business professionals, better educators, better counselors, better health professionals, better friends, and better people. As Kid President would say, y'all make everyone feel like a someone. Let's dance to the people we've served, to the students who have led us into their lives, if even for what feels like a moment, to the clients our counseling majors get the honor to work with, to the patients our kinesiology department gets to serve each day, to the community members served through the speech and hearing clinic. My fellow students and I have truly had the best experience to serve those around us, to the people who inspire us every day and remind us why we picked our career paths, the people we met who reminded us it's okay to laugh, to be silly, and to be truly honest with the people we serve, to the people we've met and loved during practicums, clinicals, internships, and various activities that made us even more passionate about our careers. Some days, the people we served may have really, really tried it, but they willingly let us into their lives, told us about their families, and allowed us to learn more from them than we could have ever imagined giving to them. When dealing with the people we will serve, may we always remember, you never know what kind of day others are having. So it is very important to remember that not everyone is having the same day as you. But the least you can do for everyone is be supportive and make everyone feel like they mean something in this world. We are about to start on a journey. These new roads will still have thorns, glass, and rocks. We won't know all the answers, and just like when we started at UGA, we'll probably be a little lost. However, now we have something different helping us. We have an education from the University of Georgia. And this is something that can never be taken away from us. This is something we get to carry with us forever. As we go into this world, let us always remember we are serving people. People who have worth, people who have dreams, and people who have the right to an education, in hopes that those things can never be taken away from them. My challenge to you comes from Kid President. Let's go out and make the world more awesome. From the heartbreaking games in Sanford Stadium to the Rose Bowl and every little moment in between. From the late nights celebrating to the friendships made in our dorms. From the moment we saw the little fireworks on our acceptance letters to now. This moment that felt like it was a long way off, but looking back, happened in just the blink of an eye. We are graduating from the University of Georgia. This university has given us opportunities we will never be able to repay. This university has given us friends we wouldn't have stumbled upon in our everyday lives. This university has turned dreams into a reality, and for that, we should have an endless amount of pride. Go Dogs!
Thank you, Autumn. That was great. Everyone has many reasons to be proud today and many reasons to celebrate. I want to take a moment to echo a few of Autumn's comments and thank the families and friends who have supported our graduates. I also want to thank the faculty and staff members who, in ways both visible and behind the scenes, have helped our graduates achieve their goals. In particular, I want to thank the staff members who have made today's convocation possible, from our Office of Student Services, our Office of Outreach and Engagement, and our Office of Instructional Technology. Thank you to all of you. Graduates, you are now alumni of the College of Education. And tucked inside those padfolios you received is a little keyboard G that you put on the G on your keyboard so everybody in every meeting you goes to knows that you're a graduate of the University of Georgia. You are now among our 60,000 living alumni. And as exemplified by Ms. Holloman, our alumni have gone on to make important contributions in Georgia, the nation, and the world. As I told you when I addressed you in the other room, I look forward to hearing about your future accomplishments, and I encourage you to stay in touch with us and let us know about the class of 2018 and what you have contributed. Now, let me invite Autumn Foss to return to the podium and lead our new graduates in the time-honored tradition of calling the dogs.
All right, graduates, stand.
Come on.
Right, in just a moment, we will wrap up this ceremony. There is not a recessional, so you can find your graduates either here or in the outer atrium. You are welcome to come up on the stage and take pictures with the arch. There's another arch out in the lobby if you want to take pictures there. Congratulations, graduates. Enjoy this celebration today and tomorrow, and always remember that you are part of something special because you are a graduate of the University of Georgia. Congratulations. Yeah.